Next we have Kaitlyn, Sien. Let's welcome Kaitlyn as she.
Hi, my name is Kaitlyn Sien, and I'm a junior at San Mateo High School. I grew up like a lot of others in the church, in a Christian home where both of my parents loved God and tried to obey His commandments. All of my life I've heard about how God loves us, but as sinners we can't be with Him in heaven. I don't know if I accepted Christ because my parents did or whatever. I do know that I didn't really understand the gospel, and I took it very lightly. But then at day camp, Auntie Jenny was teaching the missionary story, and at the end she asked if anyone would like to accept Jesus as their Savior. Being slightly older and understanding it much better, I decided to accept. Unfortunately, my walk with God was a constant mix of spiritual highs and lows. It was actually last year that I really began to doubt my faith. I had lots of questions like, how do I know the Bible is real or true, or how can I be absolutely certain of my faith? I got really excited to hear that the topics were going to be covered in church, but the way they proved the scriptures were true was by using more scriptures, and to me that was kind of circular reasoning. So I kept wondering, but I never bothered to look up the answers myself. And as I doubted, I began to ignore the things I should have been clinging to, like praying and reading my Bible. That led to me feeling completely abandoned by everyone, people at school, at church, and at home. I even felt like God had abandoned me. I was so wrapped up in my feelings, I didn't notice when people were reaching out to me. I constantly felt like everyone was too busy with other people in their lives to even pay attention to me. My thoughts went something like, no one notices me. I'm untalented. I feel invisible. I'm not good enough. Me, me, me. I. All of these thoughts were a more twisted form of pride. I'm not good enough? Well, the truth is none of us are. We are all sinners, and none of us are good enough to get to heaven. And that's why God had to send His Son to die on the cross for us. It's only Jesus who was able to resurrect from the dead, thus saving us from our sins and becoming the mediator between God and us. I messaged a friend about this, and she gave me a challenge. 2 weeks. Instead of thinking about what others can do for me, try to think about what I can do for others. It has helped me immensely to remember that the world does not revolve around me, but instead should revolve around God. That we should get out of the way and let God take over. At CBM, the theme verse was, He must increase and I must decrease, John 3:30. It has taken me quite a while to realize that I wasn't letting Him increase in my life, and even when I knew I wasn't allowing Him to do so, I didn't want to admit that I was trying to promote me. In a more twisted way, I was trying to put myself on that pedestal and say, guys, I'm up here! Look, notice me! When it should have been me at the base saying, guys, look at God! See how wonderful He is? See how amazing He is? Yet God still sought to comfort me in my prideful misery. I have heard that God loves me and He will always be there for me, but this year it really stuck. Pastor Pink told us to stick our hands in the air and say, God will never leave me. God will never forsake me. And that was from Hebrews 13:5b. And that really hit me. I wasn't alone. Even when all will just fall away, God never would. It was in these moments late at night, reflecting, that I began to actively seek Him out. Before, I'd often have questions, but I never looked up the answers myself. Now I begin to pray for the Lord, something I'd pray about but would never act upon. It felt amazing to just be able to talk to God about my troubles, hopes, and dreams. He is always there. He understands us, and He alone knows us better than we know ourselves. So why do I want to get baptized? Well, I've thought about it for a couple of years, and actually one of my counselors at the junior high camp talked about it with me. She asked why I had not. What was I waiting for? I had reasons, but I knew they weren't adequate. So I didn't tell her what they were, I just shrugged. I wasn't scared to share my testimony, because I strangely have very little fear when it comes to public speaking. But what was I really waiting for? I was waiting for that life-changing moment. In so many other testimonies, the person had a huge turnaround. One person had depression and God helped her through that. Another person had taken drugs and God helped him through that. Then there was me. Me who had lived a sheltered life and had not made a 100-degree turn. And in all honesty, did not have a great passion for Christ. Well, I know I have it now. My counselor told me baptism is a commandment using Matthew 28:19. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I said I'd think about it and push it to the back of my mind. Every so often, it popped back up and I ignored it. A couple months before camp, I finally thought about it, and was leading toward getting baptized, but I was still kind of hesitant. Then at camp, Pastor King told the story of Abraham, and he emphasized on these few words in the story. Early the next morning, God had given a commandment that Abraham should sacrifice his son, and he didn't wait. He could have said, oh, well, God didn't tell me when, so I'll just do it at lunch or in a couple of days. Early the next morning meant he went and did it immediately. He was willing to obey God's commandment and sacrifice his son straight away. So why should I wait to get baptized? If I truly love God, I will obey his commandments. Baptism is one of his commandments, so it's time for me to obey it. It's time for me to give an outward proclamation of my faith. It's time for me to give up everything, follow him, and get baptized. Thank you.
Amy, this is a real joy and an honor to baptize you as your uncle, and also to know that you are continuing a wonderful legacy of faith, not only with your mom and dad being faithful servants here at the church, but grandma and grandpa having been founders of our church, and we want to recognize their faithfulness too. But that legacy of faith would not continue unless you personally trusted Christ as your Savior. And because you have done so, you have testified to your faith, I now baptize you in the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.